The Georgia Institute of Technology has received a commitment for $30 million from the Candida Fund to build what is expected to become the most environmentally advanced education and research building ever constructed in the Southeast. The project began in earnest with a series of planning committee meetings.
Those variables are access to sunlight, access to prevailing winds.
Within this space, we've been trying to chip away at it, provide some ecological benefits beyond just the aesthetics.
After the initial planning meetings, Georgia Tech is considering several proposals by architectural firms to take on the Living Building Challenge.
I'll be with the project from start to finish, and this is exactly why I feel like I'm supposed to be an architect, projects like this.
Atlanta's a pretty fertile petri dish for experimentation and exploring an idea of this type. And we found our ideal partner here in Georgia Tech.
So what the Living Building Challenge does for us, it again raises that bar to another level to challenge ourselves to figure out how to design a building with a lot more imperatives, a lot more requirements than previously existed.
We needed to challenge both ourselves and everybody in the room about this. The old way of doing things just doesn't work anymore.
Well, the Living Building Challenge is the world's most stringent and progressive green building system, and the idea is to take the building industry as far forward as possible with sustainability, trying to not just do less harm, but actually figure out what good looks like.
It's very challenging for any kind of building, but for this building in particular, and I think that's part of the reason you wake up every morning to sort of raise the bar and try to do great things and create a campus that's a living learning laboratory for our students as the next generation of leaders who will then continue to carry the baton forward to make the world a better place.
We're just getting started, so stay tuned for more updates on the Living Building Challenge.